Dutch Passion the Train operator NS is replacing a large part of its fleet at the moment and in the years to come. Maarten Verkan is responsible for the recycling process of rolling stock at NS. His employer recently won a circular award from the Dutch government for the renovation of old trains. But this is a different part of dealing with old trains, isn't it, Maarten?
Yeah, thank you, Paul. Thank you for your invitation. Also, welcome to all ladies and gentlemen at home, at the office. I hope you enjoyed your lunch. Indeed, for NS, sustainability fulfills a very important role, even a social important role, in make the Netherlands more sustainable. And I would like to present you something about sustainability.
Yes, yes, I'm very curious how this process takes place, this demolition of the trains.
Demolition? Yeah. Used to be the demolition of this on the moment it's dismantling. Yeah. And I will present several things about sustainability. In the first place, I will introduce myself in a very short. I give you some context. I will mention the goals and the most important risks. And I give you a quick view. You were on the
yes, I saw it myself how it works.
Few years
yes.
ago, and in the end, I will present the results of recycling to upcycling.
Okay, looking forward to it.
Okay. In the first place, my name is Maarten Verkan, born in 1975, born in the south of the Netherlands, and on the moment I'm living in the bullseye of the Netherlands in Apeldoorn. Mm-hmm. I'm married with Elze, as you see in the picture, and I have two children, Nout and Imke, in the age of 2 and 4. I did mechanical engineering and a study of bachelor business administration. And I started my career at Philips, well-known electronic concern. And after two commercial companies, I started at Philips, at the Dutch Railways, 12.5 years ago.
Okay.
The first 8 years in an operational function and the last 4 years as team leader of the project department.
Okay.
And in Dutch, we got the expression, a little bit of cynical expression, the best captains are on shore. not offshore, but onshore. And for that reason, we believe in as team leader, manager, you have to understand your profession. And for that reason, I execute my own projects and, for example, dismantling trains in a circular way.
Yes, so you're really involved with the process itself on site. Not behind your desk only?
No. Even developing the process. So.
Okay, nice. Yeah.
I will take you to a little bit context about the Dutch Railways, also known the DNS. Mm-hmm. I'm not going to mention all facts or figures. It's too large and I can present the hours and hours of that. Mm-hmm. But it's we have a very green policy. For example, we are using only green energy. Mm-hmm. And to fulfill the expectations of our customers, we purchase new trains.
We see in the images which material is coming in.
Yeah.
Which is coming out. Yeah.
And of course, at the end of the lifetime of a train, you also have to dismantle, demolish in the past, but you have to dismantle trains to create place for the new trains.
Yes.
So that brings us to the urgency of dismantling of trains. In marketing terms, you have satisfiers and dissatisfiers. Dissatisfier is something that a customer expects from you. Have enough seats, and for example, or to drive your trains on time. And this is an example of a satisfier where you can surprise your customers. Right? A green company or sustainable dismantling is something where you can create your points with your customers.
Okay. Yeah.
Another reason why it's very important is that the parking yards are limited. Mm-hmm. Our infrastructure in our small country is of course limited, and you have to do something with your trains that's parked for the midterm or the long term. Mm-hmm. And in the end, the other third bullet over here is that long park terms attracts vandalism. Everybody is familiar with graffiti. And over here you see example, and you see an example 2 years ago where something took suicide mm-hmm. of long part terms. So that's the reason why to have a hurry up.
Yeah, there was a real explosion in this train with a fire, and that's nothing you yeah. want connected with your company. Of
no, 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 no. You don't want to be associated with such an incident.
No, of course. Yeah.
We've got also three goals by dismantling trains. The first example is to create a repetitive process. The coming years, as I said and mentioned, we are purchasing lots of trains, between 150 and 200 coaches a year. And on the other hand of the life cycle, you have to also to dismantle the trains.
Yes.
We defined an ambition of 100% by circular dismantling, and in the end they will give you the results of it. Mm-hmm. If we realized ambition, and therefore we, for example, we use the stairway of Lansing. As you see in the picture, I give the Dutch version and the English version.
Okay.
And
nice.
The worst you can do by demolition, for example, is to landfill your trains, dump your trains in the environment. That's the worst you can do. And mm-hmm. the very best, the most, of course, the Stairway of Heaven, familiar to the lyrics, is the best which you can do is to prevent, to build trains, for example.
Yeah.
And ambition from NS is to recycle 100%. Over here you can see it is maybe approximately in the middle.
Yeah. Okay.
And we want to set a new level in maturity and to more to recycle and reuse components than recycle, just recycle.
Okay, but you're at stage C at the moment.
Yeah. That's our ambition.
Okay.
And overall, the image about dismantling must be managed. For example, when you have to know in Holland, the trains are very crowded. In rush mm-hmm. hour, not everyone, but a lot of people have to stand in gangways mm-hmm. or in the balconies.
Yes.
For example, and when you're communicating and read something in the press or in the newspapers that the Dutch Railways is dismantling trains besides crowded trains, mm-hmm. yeah, it can be misunderstood.
Yeah.
So you have to explain the content. Very good.
Mm-hmm. Because when you talk about reuse, you're dismantling trains that maybe can still be used, but that's not the issue right now.
We do it as most as possible, mm-hmm. as much as possible. I apologize, but for example, diesel trains, you can't reuse diesel trains. It's not needed over here in Holland.
Yeah.
Of course, you can. Maybe you can sell it to other countries. And that is already been done. That mm-hmm. was one of the reasons why the trains stood for long term in Nijmegen, or parked for long term in Nijmegen. But we are continuous investigating if we can sell or upcycle trains to other railway companies.
Yes. But that's not always possible, of course.
Not always possible.
Yeah.
On the other hand, you see the relatively new double-deckers from the years of the 1980s. Mm-hmm. They are modernized on the moment in our refurbishment factory.
There are still trains being reused and refurbished, of course.
Of course,
but not every train is suitable for this approach.
No.
Okay.
We also have got several risks. You see the first three risks are safety or environment related. We are driving and maintaining the trains almost 40 years, but we have never dismantled trains. And maybe we get surprised by hazardous materials.
Mm-hmm.
And for another reason, chrome 6 and carbon dioxide, PFAS are new. Dangerous materials
where
regulation and laws are limited. they are developing on the moment. So by the time you are dismantling trains, maybe you've got new laws about that.
Yeah, yes, of course. Yeah. Is there still asbestos being discovered in trains that are being dismantled at the moment?
Very
little is left.
Yes.
On the track.
On very particular places.
Okay.
For example, where you lift the coaches.
Okay.
The places where asbestos is used.
Yeah.
40 years ago. Yes. Not on the moment anymore, but
no.
When you're dismantling the trains, you
you still see some asbestos coming up.
Yeah. A small view about how we dismantle trains. We've got four parking yards where the trains are parked. Mm-hmm. We dismantle parts or components on other locations on a safe way. You can't do it on every yard, large doors or boogies. And afterwards, we concentrate all trains in Amsterdam, the container terminal. It's a very practical location because of the fact you've got cranes over there and you can drive your lorries and trucks beside the coaches.
Yes.
Cranes can lift it off the boogies and lift it on trucks or even on boats. It's a very practical location.
Okay.
And afterwards, it's transported to other locations, for example, in Amsterdam and then in Rotterdam, over here, where we dismantle locations.
Okay. And this dismantling is contracted to special companies, or do you do that yourself?
Yeah. No, not by ourselves. We've got three companies possible to dismantle trains.
Okay.
We've contracted them. And over here you see an example of how we dismantle the trains.
Yeah, it's an electric locomotive.
Yes.
Okay.
And of course you are curious about the results.
Yes, of course. Yeah.
I said in the beginning the ambition was 100% recycling, and as you can see over here on locomotives we reach a percentage of almost 100%. Just the driver seats and the polyester front of the nose of the train is not to be recycled, and for passenger trains it's a little bit higher. Of less recyclable. You see it over here is almost 97%. That's because the reason you've got plastic ceilings, you've got a lot of seats, a lot of materials that are not recyclable.
Okay.
So when you want to more recycle your trains, you have to make the next step in the stairway, for example, and you have to go from recycling to upcycling. And NS was always reserved about with the policy about selling components or parts to non-related rail-related companies.
Okay.
And that has a particular reason. For example, when you sell a component and somebody dumps it later on in the nature, it's always be associated to the Dutch railways.
Okay.
Or when you reuse a coach and rebuild it, transform it to a restaurant or a student home, and something happens with an incident, or for example, with a fire, for example, it's always associated to NS.
Yeah, because it's so recognizable as an NS train.
Yes.
Okay.
Everything what's blue and yellow is associated with
yes,
Dutch Railways. So for that reason, we were always reserved about upcycling components.
Mm-hmm.
But the last 2 years, we made lots of experiments. And I will show you some examples
how
we are upcycling at the moment. For example, over here, you see parts of a train, a special the SGM train.
Mm-hmm.
And we created a catalog where we put in 31 parts. And we use that catalog for business-to-business selling, for architects or builders who build a cinema and need, for example, 200 seats. They can sell it from our catalog.
Ah, okay, nice. Yeah.
Yeah.
And is this already being used by people?
Yeah. This is in particular for the business-to-business market, but we also do it for the private market on the moment. We are experimenting with it.
Mm-hmm.
We did it already years ago for charity goals by volunteers of the Dutch Railways. But last year we also managed to make an agreement with the largest European auction. And on the moment you can see and sell and buy, sorry, I apologize, you can buy components from the Dutch Railways.
Oh, okay, yes.
For everybody
you can
available.
Build your own train compartment at home.
Yeah, of course. Yeah. Another example is the upcycling shop. You see it often at the Utrecht station. It's for us an opportunity to make impact on the society and to show what we upcycle on the moment, mm-hmm. and to be very proud to pronounce that we managed the most worst component to recycle. That's, as I said, the ceilings and the walls of a train. The hard plastic. It's almost impossible to recycle, and we managed to make an agreement with the largest furniture builder for offices, and they scrap the walls and the ceilings to small parts and press it into new desktops.
Oh, nice. Yes.
So for the future, we've got a commercial possible option to make more upcycling, recycling. And in summary, it's also readable at the NS website. We've got lots of stuff where you can see and buy stuff. Mm-hmm. On the website, we've also mentioned the partners, the sites, etc., etc. So for particular questions or contact, mm-hmm. It's possible to.
Yeah. Nice. Yes, looks good.
So that is in short. My small workshop in a nutshell.
Yes. And is there already a lot of interest in these products? How much is already sold of this?
It's more and more.
Okay.
It's very nice to have, for example, a dustbin and put your plants on it mm-hmm. at home.
Yes.
Instead of scrapping it and you reuse it by aluminium.
Yes, of course. Yes. Well, let's see, because the audience can also ask
okay.
questions.
Yep.
Mine are already answered with the presentation, because it was a very clear presentation. Because I was most curious, why don't you keep on using these trains?
Yeah.
But I can understand, you don't want to keep on driving diesel trains, of course, if your intention is to be more good to the environment. Well, let's have a look at the questions, because there's a lot of interest coming from the audience. Here's a question. Do you also recycle plastics, thermosets, parts of the train? Well, I think that was also answered by the desk.
Yeah.
But you also mentioned the nose cone of the locomotive. That was also made of some kind of plastic?
Yeah, also the hard plastic, but wasn't recyclable. But mm-hmm. yet we found the method to recycle it and to turn it into desks.
Okay, so this nose cone of the locomotives is also made or reused as a desk. Okay,
right.
so you could be working in the future on a desk that was once a train. Wait, that's nice. Here's someone who says, very nice story, but could you explain why the NS is taking the responsibility to recycle the trains? Is there not a tendency to train as a service in which the OEM stays owner of the train and is also responsible for high quality recycling? Well, that's an interesting topic. Have you considered this way, or is it a topic within NS?
No, yeah, it's of course it is a topic at the Dutch Railways. We made, on the moment, we are making agreements about recyclability, sustainability mm-hmm. with the new OEMs. And it's very difficult to make appointments for the moment.
Yes.
That are, how do we call it? To execute about 40 years.
Yes,
it's very
difficult. Yeah, and I think I think this is more something that we could ask, we should have asked this morning to Marion Hintel, of course, because this is her department. But we could also ask Siemens or Alstom maybe later on, because they're also part of this,
nice question,
this conference. Yes, because why not do a train as a service? What does it sound like? Like TAS, maybe. Okay, well, that's something for the future. How many trains are being dismantled at the moment at NS?
Yearly, about 150 and 200 coaches.
Okay.
And in the coming 8 years, it will be more than 1,000 coaches.
More than 1,000?
Yeah.
Okay. And which type of rolling stock is being dismantled at the moment?
On the moment, also locomotives, mm-hmm. double deckers, and sprinters.
Yes, the one you showed, which is in the web shop.
Yeah, and the catalog.
Okay. And are there also parts that are being used by NS themselves?
Yeah, of course. Several parts. Mm-hmm. We use dustbins, for example. Old furniture, old seats are used for conference call tables, quiet rooms.
Okay.
But also we use wooden floors to make, for example, table tennis tables.
So there's a lot of train parts in the office buildings of NS at the moment.
And even a soccer or football tables.
Also?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, nice.
Okay.
And you can sell them. Buy them.
Yeah. Oh, you can buy them at the NS stores at the station in Utrecht. Okay, well, let's have a look if there are still questions coming in. Well, if you would like to ask some questions to Maarten, please do not hesitate, because we still have some minutes, I think. And if there aren't any questions, then maybe I have some more. Because what is happening here in the picture? What are they doing? Because I see that there's a large part of the train has disappeared. How does this take place, this dismantling process?
On technical way, you mean?
Yeah.
Okay.
Because this seems like some giant animal has taken a bite out
almost.
Of the train.
that's indeed the situation. Our contractor has several cranes with a great
claws, something like that.
And they grip the train and cut the train in small pieces. And mm-hmm. afterwards, they pick all with the large crane. It's very impossible. It's very interesting to see.
Yes,
they pick all parts separate from copper and aluminium, steel, rubber. Plastics. It's very marvelous.
To separate all the different materials, because before this takes place, of course, all the parts that can be reused as parts are taken off.
Upcycling parts are already taken off.
Okay. So in this train, for instance, how many different materials are there left to separate? Do you have
very specified 21.
21 different materials.
Yeah.
Okay, I can imagine there's a lot of steel, and plastic was also mentioned.
Also.
What other...
Some batteries, for example. Lamp holders on the ceiling. Of course, the plastic walls, the seats. As I mentioned, the steel, aluminium, rust-free steel.
Okay.
Copper.
Yes.
Rubber, of course.
Yeah, and the glass.
The glass apart. 21
okay.
parts.
But it's being separated afterwards, so it's not taken off. Like dismantling, it really means crushing it and taking the different materials afterwards.
Yeah.
Okay. Do you have any idea why that is the chosen strategy? Not completely taking off every part and separating afterwards?
This is faster.
Okay,
it's much faster. You can dismantle on this way, you can dismantle a train in one day.
Mm-hmm.
When you unbolt everything, you've got weeks and weeks to unbolt everything.
Yeah, so this is more efficient.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, in the meantime, there's a question coming in from Jeroen Bransen. Maarten, besides dismantling and reuse of components, is NS also looking into the introduction of plant-based, recyclable, biodegradable components in their trains? Do you have any idea? Because you're involved with dismantling, so maybe this is another department, but do you know if that is something NS is investigating?
Not yet. I'm not familiar with it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so this is also a question we should ask the suppliers, the OEMs.
Yeah, or okay. I have to inform my back.
Yeah, so sorry, Jeroen, maybe we will have to come back to this in a later stage, but it's an interesting question.
Yeah. I will contact you, Jeroen.
Okay. Well, then, Maarten, thank you very much for your explanation. It was a very nice story, and also thank you to the audience for the questions.